Mini Chapter 2, The Terrace Pool at the House on Electra Drive. Jaymi's eyes open on a hot blue haze above a Hollywood hillside. Lying here, he grins with a glint in his eyes. Above him on the left, silhouetted like an asterisk upon the sky, a palm tree crest sways lazy in the heat, while cicadas chirp, hidden in the scratchy vegetation away down the slope beyond the boundary of his land. What a palace this is, spread around him here, a palace of his own. And how blessed he is to have it, as he knows. To recline by the pool on this newly won Electra Drive terrace has somehow become his ordinary world, strange to say. Actual, everyday reality for that same nervous boy who used to carry his violin around, always somewhere at the edges of the group, and so often shy and blushing, who lives somewhere inside him still. Accessed through the sliding glass doors of a huge open-plan sitting room, this ground floor terrace, with its sunbeds arrayed around a generously curved swimming pool, is only the lowest of three sunny spaces that wrap around the outside of the house on three successive levels. Furnished with elegant white armchairs and more sunbeds, the terrace on the story above him is accessed via external steps from here, or directly through the doors from his study, where a fanfare of computer monitors and gleaming IT equipment attests to his career as a games designer. And on the top floor, part shaded by the projecting width of his bedroom's shallow dome of a roof, is a yet more exclusive terrace. Set apart from the other luxury residences on Electra Drive, and further buffered from the normal world by a wide surrounding plot of unspoiled land, this house is constructed alone on a promontory of its own, overlooking the city of Los Angeles. The sunsets, sinking to the ocean on his right and far ahead, refracted through the city's haze, are chemical and poisonously gorgeous. He would not have predicted, back in Omaha, that such luxury and privilege would come to be his. Nor would he have predicted it in the course of the few years after his first arrival in Manhattan on that legendary truck he once flagged down. Years during which his childhood video games playing experience joined forces with his coding abilities to land him a position as a programmer working for the visual design team in the New York office of the games development company Bang Dead Games. By this time, his upbringing on the outskirts of Omaha felt like ancient history. The company was just entering an aggressive expansion phase after one of its titles had hit big. He wouldn't even have predicted this Electra Drive palace a year later, when he was given the exciting opportunity of being transferred to the company's main office here in LA as a higher-ranking member of the design team on another, even bigger and longer-established Bang Dead title. How well he remembers his eagerness, as the plane touched down at LAX, to be joining an HQ led by such a high-achieving bunch of thoughtful and open-minded managers who surely wanted to light up and elevate the world in the same way he did. It was so cool to know they were just as fired up by fresh and intelligent world creation as he himself was. Why, the very week he arrived here, a new senior manager joined the company with a specific brief to develop an enormous new game. Ain't They Freaky was its cheeky-sounding name, apparently, though it was months before Jaymi came to know anything much more about it, owing to the pressure and workload involved in his lightning progress up through the ranks of his own development team's game. He soon veered into the overall execution of this game's visual design. In the context of so large and well-established a game world, he was rarely called on to invent substantial new additions to its look or concept, being rather focused on overseeing sophisticated new tweaks and technical extensions of what was already there. But the multiplicity of his contributions and the speed of his rise equipped him with practical experience across an unusual variety of capacities, from project management to visual design to programming. In the context of the title's runaway commercial success, that varied experience has resulted in what Jaymi knows is an unusually fortunate paycheck. So fortunate that last month, just 4 years after joining Bang Dead, he found himself settling into this lush house on Electra Drive, spread atop a promontory facing the city, high in the Hollywood Hills. Why is it, then, that throughout this first month since he moved in, he has nonetheless continued to feel restless? What on earth more can he want than this, luxuriating here in the penthouse of his industry? Is he missing something obvious? Is there some flaw in this picture, hiding in open view, staring him in the face while he fails to see it. He closes his eyes to concentrate. His fingers are distracted by the texture of the sunbed he's lying on. He allows his focus to come trotting back like a little dog and bids it sit and contemplate the question at hand. Yes, the question, which was, what was it again? Ah, yes, the floor in the picture, staring out at him from the shadows in the pattern. He thinks hard. The hiss, swirl, patter of the sprinkler on his lawn is carried to him, soft on a warm breeze up the hillside, while those lines of Italian cypresses on the far canyon slopes stand dark behind the heat haze. He really is restless. There's no getting away from it. And it's something to do with Bang Dead. The hiss and swirl continue, but mixed with more patter than before. The wind must be veering the water jets to one side, away from concentricity, to splatter onto the wider-leaved plants that push up through the rocky hillside earth around the edges of his artificially planted lawn of springy turf. Some scent of voltage, some transcendence or vengeance or fierce beauty somehow, is absent or elsewhere.